So this is about the ampersand substitution. So that is single ampersand substitution. But in Oracle, we also have double ampersand substitution. So what is double ampersand substitution? Now assume this, guys, in this query, you have only one substitution, right? Sometimes it might happen that you have to substitute the same variable multiple times. Okay, double ampersand substitution. Now assume that, guys, in your query there are 5 variables that you want to substitute. Just an assumption. Now out of those 5 variables, 3 variables are same. Now in this case, you are duplicating your efforts, right? It might happen. So this is all I'm giving you real world scenarios. So let us assume you have a query like select ampersand column from hr.employees, where ampersand column is equal to 50. Okay, this is the query. So this column is something we want to substitute. Now in this query, we have got this column 2 times, right? This is like first time over here and again in the where condition. Now in real time, when you have some big queries, there might be like 11 times the same ampersand variable is being substituted. Now in such situation, what you can do is the first variable, you can make it double ampersand. So this way, SQL will ask the column variable only once, and it will substitute wherever the same ampersand variable appears in the entire query. So it will not ask you for 2 times. For example, let us run it without the double ampersand. So what happens? So first of all, I'm running this query. So it will ask us for column value. So this is the first ampersand variable value select. So I want to select department underscore ID and I'm clicking on OK. And under the where condition also we have column, right? Where department ID is equal to 50. So department ID and click on OK. So we got this output. Now see, this is a very simple query, but in the same query, we had to substitute column names 2 times, even though the substitution variable is same. In a very big queries, if you have the same ampersand variable multiple times, it becomes hard to substitute same value again and again. And it's actually stupidity to substitute same value 11 times, for example. So what you can do is the first column that you have, you use double ampersand. So you will use another ampersand and then run this query. Now when you run this query, in the column, what I'm going to put is department underscore ID and I'll click on OK. Now can you see it didn't ask us for the second time the value for the column variable. So this way, when you have big queries, it becomes hard to substitute same variable again and again. So instead of that, the first occurrence of the variable, what you can do is you use double ampersand. You use another ampersand like this. So this is called as double ampersand substitution. So once you substitute or put value like this, the SQL in your session, the column variable has been assigned with the same value. So what do I mean by that? See, if I want to run another query, select first underscore name from hr.employees, where ampersand column is equal to 20. Now in this case, let us run this query. Now you guys should have a doubt, like why the query didn't ask us what exactly is ampersand column, because if you use double ampersand, your session will store the value of this column. like the first time when we ran this query, what happened is within your session right now, the ampersand column, C-O-L-U-M-N, is equal to department, D-E-P-A-R-T-M-E-N-T, department underscore ID. So now going forward, even if you run any query that contains the same variable called ampersand column, then it will automatically substitute it with department ID. It won't ask you to substitute the value again.